Welcome once again to 76ers basketball here with Serena Winters. I'm Mark Zumoff. Ala Abdanabi has the night off. How about that Shake Milton going viral a couple of games ago?
Are you kidding me? If you did not know Shake Milton before the weekend, you sure know him now. 39 points against the Clippers, and he did it all in L.A. He showed everybody the 7-foot wingspan that he has. You can see it right there. He's just so elusive.
And what to watch do is you have to defend the three. This is a team that likes to get them up, and you all know about De'Aaron Fox. You have to slow him down, limit him getting into that painted area, guys, and force him right. He is so good at going to his left. If you want to do anything, Mark, you want him shooting that shot. You'd rather see him try to take that three than allow him inside.
Yeah, I'll say at 32%, that's well below the NBA average.
And that's been something he has added to his arsenal as Tobias Harris knocks down that three. But he was telling me today that that was something that pull-up three he's really been working on this season. And he's one of those guys, Mark, you have to watch out for because he is a hustle player, a 50-50 ball guy. And as you saw it right there, a guy who can get some boards. And talking to some Kings people just about that whole decision to put Buddy Hield in that second unit, one of the reasons, guys, is Bjelica and Bogdanović, they played together on the Serbian national team. So they wanted to see if we could get some continuity between those two guys. And this is what you love to see from Tobias Harris, just being aggressive, beating him off the dribble, showing his quickness there. He wishes he had the foul call, but hey, he got all the way to the rim quite easily. Exactly what you were just talking about, that feed from the high post, beautifully delivered. And Tobias Harris with the easy one. Thinking Al Horford, Mike Scott with the hustle play. You love that. But then the defense there, the quick hands by Alec Burks. And Zoo, one of the things I've liked most about the start to this game is at least seeing that aggression from Tobias, trying to put his imprint on this game, because you know the Kings have him high up on the scouting report. You'd think number one.
That is the voice of Serena Winters, adding color analyst to her duties tonight for Ala Abdanabi, who has the night off.
And look, it's not like Neto's not putting in the effort against Fox right now, who makes that free throw. It's just that Fox is so quick, he can use that speed to get a guy off him, and that's exactly what he's doing. Just changes direction so quickly.
Yep.
It's pretty rare you actually see Matisse get those calls as a rookie, right? It was just too easy for Fox. That is exactly what's on the scouting report. He will take advantage of you there. Tobias Harris has been having himself a heck of a night, knocking them down from deep just with persistence. And look, Tobias has had several good games. He's been shooting 55% over the past three games. He's really been working on his game, knowing that he's got to step up. 25.7 points per game over the last three. Sometimes you do want to see him draw a little bit more contact and get to the line a little bit more. And Bazemore has done big things for this Kings team as well, especially late in games. But Shake Milton, take a look at this. Just split the D, getting straight to the hoop. Man, he's been fun to watch, Sue.
And tonight we are happy to be joined by Serena Winters, who is here for Ala Abdanabi, who has the night off. How about the Sixers outscoring the Kings 27-6 from beyond the arc in the first half?
Absolutely. I mean, Brett was talking about you have to attack from beyond with the personnel that they have. And then also, we talked about it, a key to this game for the Sixers is defending the three. So those are two things they have been doing very well. The second half, though, Mark, I would like to see a little bit more physicality, especially defensively, off-ball physicality, and see if they can get on a nice little run here in the third. I feel like a broken record here, but I'm going to say it again. You want to see the aggressiveness from him. And yes, look, he was knocking down threes, but what I like even more is this play right here, because he is attacking the rim, getting to the paint, using his size. Something Brett mentioned at shoot-around this morning is you've got Matisse, who's maybe your best perimeter defender, but you also want to shoot threes, and he's not exactly the reliable three-point shooter you need, so that is something you've got to figure out, yep. The balance of that. What a pretty move there by Shake. So smooth. The timing on that, too, on the release, so that didn't get blocked. Take a look at this right here. Something else I like about him, Mark, is his moves don't seem predetermined. He really does react to what the defense has given him. But this is exactly what you want to see, that physicality that I talked about wanting to have in that second half. Bodies on the floor. Zoo, I feel like Neto always has those sneaky moves when he's in the game. You can always count on Howell Neto for a play like this, where he's just slippery getting to the basket. And that's not easy with his size. The fact that he's able to do that and draw the foul, it's pretty impressive. the storyline has changed now, Mark. A few weeks ago, you're talking about just them rebuilding. Now you're talking about that eighth spot. That is something that they can certainly attain. And Zoo, I really think that one of the reasons we've seen so much success recently from this Kings team is because they just decided to make a change, and that was putting Buddy Hield coming off the bench. And that's not to say that the talent doesn't make him a starter. It's that sometimes you just need a shakeup, and I think in this case you did. And it's also allowed De'Aaron Fox to really thrive in that starting unit, and he's taken his game to another level.
Nice.
And look, if you're the Sixers, you've got to watch out, because this Kings team just came back from a 21-point deficit the other night against Detroit. We talk about guys staying ready all the time, Mark, and Neto is certainly an example of another guy like Shake Milton that just stays ready, because there's some nights where his number isn't called, but yet he still comes in that next day and puts up performances like this. That three was possible because of Al Horford. He set such a solid screen there to get Alec wide open. And that's just all credit to Alec there, because that wasn't a great pass from Al Horford, usually something he's so good at. And Alec just saw the shot clock and knew what to do. And something that Glenn Robinson III told me the other day is, look, when you come to a new team, you've also got to show your teammates your tendencies and what you like. You have to get them used to you, just like you got used to the plays out there. And Mark, you just make a great point about the bench points, because keep in mind in perspective that the Sixers are already without Joel and Ben and Josh. You're already so shorthanded. So to be able to get those points off the bench is huge. Just fourth quarter, watch out for De'Aaron Fox trying to take it over, because that has been a tendency of his, is just to try to close these games and put the team on his back. And Mark, the difference has really been the three-point shooting. It starts out here with Buddy Hield, but remember, the Sixers allowed just 2 of 8 from the three in that first half, and then Bogey hits from deep there. And look, you're going to see Buddy Hield close out this game. And let me tell you something about Buddy. Even though it's been, what, 17 games now since he has had this new role, he still has got an ego, right? He still feels like he has got something to prove out there. You're going to see him close this game and try to put his imprint on it as well. And you can't leave him that wide open there, Mark. You just can't do that. We're talking about the point guard mentality from Shake Milton, the poise you've heard us say. Did you see that right there? Did you see that beautiful ball fake before he got it into Al Horford? Check that out. It was quick, but it was so important, because that allowed an easier feed to Al for the easy deuce. Mark, you've just got to love the aggression that Tobias Harris has showed from the start of this game. He's talked about knowing that he's got to step up with the other guys out, and I think tonight he's really showed that. Without Joel, without Ben, without Josh, to get a win on the road out of all places, how important was this?
You know when the last time we won on the road? January 20th in Brooklyn. So, you know, first offense.
You've been keeping track.
Oh, yeah, of course.